Hey everyone, Cory here with another DIY, and today we're going to be changing the thermostat and water pump on this B8.5 S4 behind me. Now this is a fairly extensive job, so I wouldn't recommend it for the first time DIYer, but if you've been wrenching on your car for a while, you should be good to go. There are a couple shortcut ways to change both of these very quickly, but I'm going to be taking the time to put the front of the car in the service position, one for the camera and two so you guys can have a better understanding about what I'm doing. With the supercharger off, now would be a great time to change the PCV valve as well, but we are going to be saving that for another video. So these two parts right here were a huge problem for the B8 S4 when they first came out, but by now most of the cars should have the updated parts, so I would recommend changing them at least every 100,000 miles. So there may be some small inconsistencies along the way changing these parts, but it's relatively the same for all models across the Audi platform that came with the 3.0T. So I have 2 gallons of coolant, the short plastic pipe for under the supercharger, the O-rings for the front coolant pipe, all the supercharger gaskets, thermostat, the water pump. Being a B8.5, it does have the vacuum nipple for the shroud that goes around the coolant pump. We have the supercharger belt and the accessory drive belt. Now we do have a pre-made kit for these items, so just see the description below. So these are the tools required for this job. Quarter inch ratchets and quarter inch sockets are an absolute must, and a small 2-inch quarter inch extension will be very helpful as well. And you're definitely gonna want a good flashlight so you can see down in the engine bay. So enough talking, let's dive right in. So first, we're going to start out by taking off the under tray. If this had an OE under tray, as you can see here, it has a very nice aluminum one available on our site in case you're interested. It would have a bunch of these twist lock fasteners. This is a T25. It's normally not here. And these are 5 mils. As you can see here, we got remnants of coolant leakage. So you can drain the coolant with this nipple here. It's just a little twist seal on this side here. You can pop the radiator hose off. Sometimes they are a pain. Or you can come over here and just disconnect this hose here and then the hose on the oil cooler here. So we're gonna try not to make a mess. We'll see what happens. So I'm just gonna plug these hoses back in for now, so it doesn't make a huge mess. So while we're under here, I'm gonna take off this T30 for the coolant pipes right here. So since we're gonna be putting the car in service mode, I'm gonna take off these two T30s and then these three T30s while we're under here. Now, sometimes you may have trouble with these as they get scraped a lot and get worn down. So just tap a socket into it if need be. So we're gonna take off this T25, and this little clip here. I'll show you guys how to take off these clips. So you have to pry up on this end because there's a little lock right there. And it'll pop off. Now, if I can peel the fender liner back and lock it into the tread on the tire there. And then there's a 10 millimeter bolt in there that is attaching the bumper. Now it definitely helps to have a little wobble or a U-joint on your extension. Repeat that for the other side. So now we're going to take off the upper radiator cover here. These clips are simple. Just push them down a little bit. You'll hear a pop, and then work it up. It'll pop right off. So now we're going to take off these two fasteners. Typically, if I remember correctly, they're T20s. These are not the correct fasteners. These are T25s. So I'm just taping up the edges of the front fender real quick. Doesn't have to be perfect, but just enough to give it a little bit of protection just in case you scrape it. So now we're gonna pop the edges of the bumper. Unplug this foglet here. Fender right there. Unplug this fog light. Yeah, there's a little tab there as well. So now we're going to unplug the bleeder line right here. Just so when the nose tilts forward, it's not pulling on it. And then we're gonna unplug both headlights. So this one's pre-broken. You can see the back tab is off. So if it doesn't just pull off, what you can do sometimes, if it's not broken all the way and it still has the little tab inside it, is you can reach down in here with a pick and pop it up lightly. Now we're going to remove the three 16 millimeter bolts on both sides of the bumper support beam. So now we're going to be taking off two T30s, one here and one on the other side. Then we can move the nose forward just enough to get lots of clearance here. So now I'm just going to loosen the water pump pulley bolts while there's still a lot of tension. They may be a little corroded on the inside, so you may have to tap them all the way in because they can strip easily. So just wiggle it in. These are a 10 millimeter triple square. There's one. There we go. So that's loose. So now we're going to take off the engine covers and start disassembling everything. And we're going to undo the supercharger drive belt. Now, if you're going to be reusing this belt, make sure you mark the drive direction. This is a 16 millimeter. So just rotate the automatic tensioner. And pop the belt off. Now we're going to take off the intake. Since this is aftermarket, it is slightly different than taking off the OEM airbox over here, but it's relatively the same. Take off the hose on the backside. 8 millimeter nut drive. This is not attached, so we'll just wiggle it out. So now I'm just going to stuff the intake tube with some rags and blow out the channels right here, just so nothing drops in. We're just going to mark this vacuum line right here so we know which one is which. Little dot, you know that line goes there. These are pretty self-explanatory. So these are stuck on there pretty good. So just twist them a little bit, but be careful doing that because these nipples are easy to break. go. So we're going to unplug all the electrical connectors in this area here. You have this valve here, these two solenoids, evap purge valve, and a manifold pressure sensor in the back here, as well as the throttle body down here. So the purge valve has one of the little white locks on it. So this little white lock is stuck. So we're going to coax it free real quick. There we go. So the white lock moved back. And now you can press the tab and take off the connector. A good way to get off these stuck connectors, if you feel like they're stuck, push them forwards a little bit to release tension off of this tab. And then it'll lift right up. Yeah, these are on there good too. You can also get a pick in here and lift that up. That's that. You have the throttle valve here. Map sensor in the back. And then the throttle body down here. You also have these two map sensors on the sides here. So we're just going to pull off this line for the evap valve. There we go. So now we're going to take off these little plastic coverings right here. These are T25s. So now we're going to take off the two coolant hoses on the front of the supercharger here. So now we're going to take off this T30 on the front coolant pipe. There's one. Now we're going to take off the 6 13mm of the supercharger plenum. So make sure all the wiring is free, the vacuum lines out of the way, and I like to use extensions as handles. So let's just double check. Got these in front of it. It's loose. Everything is loose on the back side. You got the map sensor. Okay. Up and away. Now we're going to take the vacuum and just clean up anything in the surrounding area. So since we already cracked the water pump pulley bolts loose, we can just take our 16mm wrench and take off the serpentine belt. If you're going to reuse this, make sure you mark the rotation direction. So to get the serpentine belt completely out, you have to take off this idler pulley to get the belt past it. 10mm triple square. Now we can take out the bolts for the water pump pulley. So now you can see the vacuum line that the B8.5s have. This is for a shroud that covers the water pump impeller, which obviously restricts flow and allows a quicker warm-up for emissions purposes. The B8s do not have that. So now we're going to loosen the coolant pipe here.
there is a teeny tiny little T25 screw right there. Do not forget about that. You can see your water pump was flinging some coolant around. So now we're going to move the secondary air hose right here. We're just going to lift up on this tab on this side. See it move a little bit, lift up on the other tab. And out she comes. So now we are loosening the four T30 fasteners for the front coolant pipe.
Now the, if you were just changing the thermostat, the flat rate way would be to just loosen those bolts and pry this off a little bit so you can get the thermostat out. So now we're going to loosen the seven T30s, holding the thermostat in. Yeah, let me just scrape the front a little bit. Now we're ready to install the thermostat. So now these get torqued to 9 newton meters. I would do multiple passes as they will loosen up. There we go. Now your thermostat is replaced. So now we're going to change out all the O-rings on the coolant pipe here. So there's one in the middle and two on either side. These are already stuck to the cylinder heads. So now I'm going to fish these O-rings in here. Lubricate them a little bit with the coolant in the pipe. There's one. And the other, you can't really see. There we go. Now I put a new O-ring on the center of the coolant pipe here. Now, put it back into place. Get that started. And we'll line up the bolts. So now I put a little bit of grease on the end of the bolt here, just so it sticks on there nice. I'm going to reach in here and start the bolts for the coolant pipe. Oh, oh. There's one. There's the other. There's two. I'm just tightening it a little bit. So these T30s also get torqued to 9 newton meters. So now we're just going to finish the coolant pipe installation. So you really don't want to go tight at all because it'll strip out real easy. There we go. So now I'm just going to undo the little vacuum line here. So now we're going to take off all the T30s. For the water pump. Yeah.
moving a little bit. There we go. Lubricating the gasket. And putting the new coolant pump in place. Start one bolt. And starting two. Now these also get torqued to 9 newton meters.
There we go. All right, so now we just have to button a few things up on the front of the motor. The vacuum line for the water pump.
There we go. Electrical connector for that solenoid there. Electrical connector for the coolant sensor. There you go, two clicks. That's that. So now let's just make sure. That's that. Just clipping in the vacuum lines again.
Now we're gonna install the water pump pulley. I like to Loctite these bolts.
Just trying to line one up. There we go. Now those are loose.
We can install the big serpentine belt. So now we are going to install the serpentine belt.
To make this easier for you guys, we will have a diagram up on the screen. That's on. Okay.
Now for the other pulley. And this is a 10 millimeter triple square and it gets torqued to 40 newton meters. Now we can torque the water pump pulley bolts. These get torqued to 20 newton meters. And they are a 10 millimeter triple square. So the pulley end belt will try to spin a little bit. If you press your thumb against it, it's enough friction to torque it down. So now we're gonna change the old coolant pipe for the new one. I'm gonna put its blanket back on. Tuck it in. Now we're going to change all of the green seals for the supercharger. So I'm just going to take a little bit of oil just on the top here. Now it's time to throw the supercharger back on. There you go. Now just be patient with it. Make sure nothing's getting hung up in the back. And make sure it goes down nice and smooth. So now we're gonna install all the supercharger nuts. Now these get torqued to 22 newton meters. So you kinda wanna do them in a crisscross pattern. In two passes. All right. Now we're just going to install the supercharger belt, attach these two front hoses, attach the T30 here, and then lift up the nose and attach it briefly so we can connect this hose and fill it with coolant and leak check before we do anything else. So now we're going to throw on the supercharger belt.
This belt is super tight. Here we go.
Now we're just going to reattach these coolant hoses, put in this T30.
So now we're going to lift up the front end. Hold that in place.
So now we can attach that hose to our vacuum filler. So now we're going to let the vacuum bleeder sit for a little bit and make sure it maintains a vacuum. So this has no problem holding vacuum, so we're going to go ahead and fill it with coolant. So if you do not have a vacuum filler, you would pour coolant in like any other car, rev it up to 2000 RPMs and crack the supercharger bleeders in the back. And also you would crack the heater core hose in the cowl here. These cars usually do a pretty good job of self-bleeding, but I would highly recommend cracking these two screws. But disclaimer, if you do that, have new bleeder screws handy. So now I'm going to reinstall the side covers here and these two T25s. And the map sensor. Except the other side is just clips. So now we're going to plug in and reinstall all the solenoids and vacuum lines on the back of the supercharger here. This one goes here, and we know this one goes here because we marked it previously. Black plug goes to the black solenoid. Gray plug goes to the gray solenoid. Line for that air bypass. And this for the purge solenoid. And also throttle body, and then the line for the purge solenoid. So now we're going to reinstall the intake. And don't forget the breather line pack here. And these clamps are 8 millimeters. So before I do anything else, I'm just going to fire up the car real quick and run it for 30 seconds just to make sure everything's happy. Now we're just going to plug back in the headlights. And now I'm going to raise the car up and reattach the bumper support.
So as you can see, I have to lift up a little bit to get one started, and then the rest should fall into place. We'll just double check that we are on our witness marks. And I got one more, but I just need to get my U extension.
So now we can reattach the T30s on the top of the radiator support here. One there.
So now we can plug in the fog lights and reinstall the front bumper. One fog light, two fog light.
Here we go.
See that size?
These are T25s, but they should be a little smaller of a bolt. So now we can reinstall this panel.
Reinstalled
the decorative covers. So now I'm going to reinstall the 10 millimeter on the bumper cover. There we go. Now I'm going to reinstall the T25. There we go. And this one was already missing, so I just have the clip up here. So now I'm going to reinstall the 10 millimeter on the bumper cover. Now I'm going to reinstall the T25. So lastly, I'm just going to install the T30 for the coolant pipes down here. There we go. So now we're going to take these long T30s for the radiator support bracket. Then the shorter ones for the bottom of the bumper cover. Now we can install the under tray. Nothing there. Or not. There. There we go. So in conclusion, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. We replaced the water pump and the thermostat on this B8.5 S4, as well as the supercharger belt, and the serpentine belt as well. So if you have any questions about the process, please leave a comment below and we'll get back to you. If you like this video, click that like button. And if you want to see more Audi content, please be sure to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.